Good afternoon everyone, my name is Vice Chairman Molly. Now I am going to deal the subject with services and service oriented architecture. Service oriented architecture. So in this, the first topic is evaluation of distributed systems. So the first topic is about evaluation of distributed computing. So evaluation of distributed computing. So what do you mean by distributed computing? First, suppose if there are any 4-5 systems which are interconnected with one another, so to send some file or any data from one system to another system, that process is called distributed computing, right? So the definition of the distributed computing is the process of sending data or file from one system to another system is known as distributed computing. So for example, we can take World Wide Web, right? World Wide Web, so which is known as WWW, right? So here, in this, what we will do? We will, if you are a client, you will open this thing www on one system and try to send a data from Mozilla Firefox through Gmail or anything from one system to another system. So this is the architecture of this. So here we are sending this through network, right? So this is network 1, this is network 2, this is network 3, this is system 1, this is system 2, and this is system 3. So what is here? The data will be sent from one system to another system via a network cable, right? So this is the architecture of distributed computing. What it is? A file or a data is being sent from one system to another system via a network cable. So this is the architecture of distributed computing. So here, what are the advantages of distributed computing? So advantages of distributed computing is it is easily shareable. So here the advantages of this distributed computing is, first one is easily shareable, means we can send the data from one system to another system easily via network cable using this distributed computing. And next thing is, it is much more efficient than the traditional computing, because if the file is being found here, the same duplicate file will be found in another system. First, suppose the system 1 has been crashed and file 1 is being lost, then you can find the duplicate of that file 1 in the another system, in the S2, so that the file will be recovered from one system to the another system, right? So these are the advantages of that distributed computing. So next,
చేస్తున్నాను సార్ చేస్తుంటాను లాస్ట్ వన్
డిస్ట్రిబ్యూటెడ్ కంప్యూటింగ్ సో దేర్ ఆర్ ఫైవ్ టెక్నాలజీస్ ఆఫ్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూటెడ్ కంప్యూటింగ్ ఫస్ట్ వన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ client server model second one it is Kerberos third one
సంజయ్ ప్రియాంక ఇక్కడ ఇక్కడ
మైక్రోసాఫ్ట్ నెక్స్ట్ ఫిఫ్త్ వన్ ఎంఓఎం సో దీస్ ఆర్ ద ఫైవ్ టెక్నాలజీస్ విచ్ ఇస్ బీన్ కమ్స్ అండర్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూటెడ్ కంప్యూటింగ్ వన్ ఇస్ క్లయింట్ సర్వర్ మోడల్ నెక్స్ట్ వన్ కార్బా థర్డ్ వన్ ఇస్ జావా ఆర్ఎంఐ ఫోర్త్ వన్ ఇస్ మైక్రోసాఫ్ట్ ఈఎం అండ్ ఫిఫ్త్ వన్ ఇస్ ఎంఓఎం So now I am going to explain you about client server model. So here what you will do means in this we have four clients client 1 client 2 client 3 client 4 client 4 so this is client 1 this is client 2 this is client 3 this is client 4 so next we have server this is server so what is this here we have four clients client 1 client 2 client 3 client 4 and one server so what we will do the client will request the data and here we will have a database DBMS so first suppose a client requests a file or any source which we are the client wants it will be requested to the server and the server will check whether the file is being present in the DBMS or not so if the DBMS if the file is being sent it is in the DBMS it gives to the server then the server will give the response So in the same way, other clients will also request the data and get the response from the client.
Coming across client-server model.